get ready to match the stars. Stu Gilliam, Brett Summers, Jack Klugman, Stephanie Edwards, Richard Dawson, and Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rivers.
Hello there. Thank you. Hello, Johnny Olson. Thank you very much. I greet you, celebrities, welcome you, and ask you to give a very brief round of applause for Richard Dawson's new mustache.
Oh, yay!
That's enough. It's a very small mustache, but it will get bigger, won't it?
I'm not going to shave until the price of beef goes down.
All right. Now, how about a round of applause for our current champion? Here is Grady Ham. Hello, Grady. Those of you who were watching last time know that Grady has a total amount of cash of $1,550. As the time expired last time, he had just won another game and had gone through the audience match part of it successfully and got the $500 answer, and now he is going for $5,000. And we shall start that procedure right after we start this. All right, as you know, Grady has won the $500 in the audience match, and that means he's going to go for 10 times that amount in the head-to-head match here with one celebrity. He'll be playing for $5,000, so now it's time to choose a celebrity.
Stu, please.
Okay. I point out to you and to Stu, in the head-to-head super match here, they must be exact matches. All right, Stu, you get ready to write. You face me, Grady. And this is it. For $5,000, Stu, please write your answer to this. Blank side. Blank side, S-I-D-E. Okay, Stu is finished. Now, Grader, we call for your response. How do you fill in that blank? Blank side.
Outside.
He says outside. All right, Stu, for $5,000, may we see your answer, please?
I tried my very best, but I have inside.
What about that?
We had an inside and an outside. Did you debate about whether to say inside or outside?
Yes.
You did?
In or out.
All right, so he went in, you went out. And I'm sorry that never the twain shall meet there. Okay, so you've got $1,550. You're still the current champ, and that means you're going to play another game and meet another player. And here comes that player right now, Deborah Nystrom. Hi, Deborah. There's Grady Ham. Nice to have you with us, Deborah.
Thank you.
Would you like to tell us a little bit about yourself? Would you like to hear a little bit about Deborah?
Well, I wish my wife wasn't here, is all I wish.
Tell us about yourself, Deborah.
I'm a model and actress, and I work mostly as a secretary.
Mostly as a secretary?
Right. Dry period.
Very pretty lady. I don't know why you shouldn't work as an actress and as a model there. Who has a job? Well, no, that's another show. All right, Deborah, you know that you and Grady will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. You'll have two chances. The one who has done that most often at the end of the second round wins, gets the $100, then goes on to the super match where you have a shot at $5,000. All right, challenger, would you please make a selection?
I'll take A.
Some of our contestants find some questions harder than others, and that's why we ask you to make the selection. Everyone plays, because this is a brand new game. Are you ready?
Gotcha.
This is it. The psychiatrist said to his secretary, "My next patient thinks he's a dog, so whatever you do, don't act like a blank." Psychiatrist is speaking to the secretary. Got it?
Of course I don't have it. If I had it, I wouldn't be here.
I'm not just saying that.
They're already here, and they're already up there. All right, Deborah, may we hear your response to this? The psychiatrist said to his secretary, my next patient thinks he's a dog, so whatever you do, don't act like a blank.
Cat.
Cat is her answer. Let's see if she scores with that. Stu, may we see your answer?
Well, I had something a bit different in mind because since he was leaving, I thought that he shouldn't act like a tree.
A tree. Don't pose as a tree. With big branches. Okay, Brett, what do you say?
Well, I say that Jack Klugman chose to room with Richard Dawson as opposed to me. That's a true thing.
It is.
Yes.
I'm sick about it.
Now, you have to give that a lot of... I said cat.
Cat. All right. Can you score with that, Deborah? You have a little rebuttal there and an answer for us?
Tree, I said.
He said tree. Tree
and cat. Because I always had dogs with weak kidneys.
All right, Stephanie, what do you say?
Well, I'm confused. I thought I'd think more like a girl who works most often as a secretary, because I do, too. Then I would like the fellas, but I chose the word tree.
Tree. Okay. Oh. All right, what does the sage one with a little bit of fuzz under his nose have to say?
Well, that's great. I said, whatever you do, don't act like a bitch.
Okay. Don't act like
a
female
dog. Isn't it?
Right, a lady
it's a
dog.
Technical term.
Yes. Okay.
Well, would you walk this for me after the show?
Betty, her answer is cat.
Well, everybody else is barking up the wrong tree because I think it's cat.
Cat. So you scored twice with that, Deborah. All right, Grady, this one is yours. This is Grady's half of the round. Everyone participates.
Oh.
Joe's tongue was so long, he could touch his blank with it. Joe's tongue was so long, he could touch his blank with it. Grady, are you thinking of an answer while they're writing?
Unfortunately.
All right. Brett, we're waiting for your answer.
Oh, I'm right with you, sweetheart.
All right,
here,
now she's ready. How do you respond to this, Grady? Joe's tongue was so long, he could touch his blank with it.
His chest.
His chest.
Real long tongue.
Okay, boy, that is some tongue. Down to here. How about that for a tongue?
I mean, man, was he tired.
That's right. You can use it for a necktie. Just leave it hang out there, to button it up here, and that's it. All right. What do you say, Stu?
Well, I went in the opposite direction. I felt that his tongue would be so long that he could touch his nose.
Touch his nose with it. Okay. No match there, Brett. He's looking for chess.
I'm very disappointed in Grady, but it's all right. I forgive you. And I actually realized that you can easily without a lot... touch your knee, which is what I said.
Oh, yeah.
You don't need a long time.
I don't need a long tongue for that.
No.
Okay, nice try, Jack.
If you got a mouth as big as hers, you will have a tongue that will touch your knee. Mine, I went, we seem to agree a lot. Maybe you and I should room together.
Hey, Jack, that nose. No match
that
there.
That would be an odd couple.
Grady Ham's answer is chest. Stephanie?
Grady, I'm so sorry. I took something safer. Chin.
Little chin there. Not a bad answer. Okay, Richard, what do you say?
Could touch his back.
Oh, boy.
Now he had the cleanest back in town, but yes. That didn't help Grady at all.
No, I would love
Betty, to. Betty, Grady's looking for chest. What do you
I know. Yeah, well, everybody's got to have a hobby. Unfortunately, I said no.
No. So, Grady, you didn't score with that. Thought we had a lot of fun, and we'll have more fun with round two. I hope Deborah is leading 2-0 at the end of round one, and we'll get to round two right after this. Round one has been concluded. Our challenger is ahead 2-0. We go to round two and ask our challenger, Deborah Nystrom, to make a selection.
I'll stick with A.
A was lucky for you last time. You think it'll be lucky for you this time? All right. Now, last time around, Deborah, you matched Brett and Betty. So you'll be trying to match the other four players now. Brett and Betty, you lay out, all right? David.
What'd you say?
He says it every week. You lay out. And I don't understand it, and I don't want you to discuss it.
Well,
that's my wife, sir.
I mean, Brett and Betty will not participate in this question.
Now, why did you just say that in the first place? Go ahead, sir.
Here we go.
I don't know why they always put me in the militant section.
Yes.
Are you ready, Stu?
I'm ready if I don't get to go. Yeah.
You will participate here. David blanked into the Grand Canyon.
Oh, I wish I could answer that one.
I think you're thinking of another program, folks.
Oops, I dropped it. Let us right because we had gotten the answer right the last time. However.
All right, Stu, are you ready? Stu is ready, so Deborah, we call on your response. David blanked into the Grand Canyon.
Shouted?
He shouted into the Grand Canyon to hear his echo. Stu, what do you say?
Well, I had something slightly different. I really wanted to say he expectorated, but I couldn't spell it, so I put down spit.
Okay. We're looking for a shout into the Grand Canyon, Jack. What have you got for us?
Well, I just hope I spelled it correctly. I don't remember. Spit.
Spit, yeah. That's
Did
it.
I? Good.
Okay. Stephanie, shout into the canyon.
They're going to think I'm rooming with them, because so far we're agreeing with everything.
Everybody's spitting into that beautiful Grand Canyon.
Mine wasn't spit.
What did you say?
Never do that, by the way, if the wind is coming.
Yes, that's true.
I'd be a very classy road expectorate.
Yeah.
That's right.
So, Deborah, you didn't score with that. Now, I point out to you, Grady, you must match two celebrities to stay in the running. Three, however, will win the game. Bill and Marcia.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. We're having a lovely evening. Evening.
Evening.
Bill and Marcia, we're having a lovely
getting
evening.
Getting so old, they can't even read it.
Until the blank collapsed. Bill and Marcia, we're having a lovely evening until the blank collapsed.
It's a perfectly straight question, and we'll give it a perfectly straight answer.
Your answers may be good, but then again, they may be rotten. So no help, if you please. Thank you. For your enthusiasm, however, we don't want to dampen that. Everybody finished over there. All right, Grady, may we ask your response? Bill and Marcia were having a lovely evening until the blank collapsed.
Gonna have to say bed.
Bed is what he says. All right.
You do not have to say
two
bed.
Two to tie, three to win. Stu, what have you got?
I must say that he is now starting to pick up them vibrations, because I also felt the same feeling bed.
All right, there's one. Now, Brett.
Remembering my honeymoon, which is a little hard, I said bed.
Okay, that ties the score.
Go ahead, sweetheart.
All right, Jack, if you give us a bed, he wins another game.
I figure if she could lie, I could lie too. Bed.
That wins the game. Congratulations, baby. Would you step around, please? So there's another $100. Okay. Deborah, I'm sorry to see you go. We wish you good luck with your acting and modeling careers, and we have a gift for you backstage, and our most sincere thanks for being with us on Match Game 73. Bye, Debbie. All right, Grady, there it is again. Are you ready for it?
Yes. Let's go.
Okay, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Girl blank. The answer given most often by that audience is worth $500 if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now, you may solicit answers from three celebrities, and they're allowed to help in that respect, so choose them one at a time.
Let's start with Stu.
Stu, how would you fill in that blank? Girl blank.
Do I say this orally?
Yes, say it orally.
I don't write it down.
Don't write it. Just
friend.
Say. Girlfriend is what he says. All right, one more.
Stephanie.
Girl talk.
Girl talk. Okay, you've got two now, Grady. One more.
Richard.
Girl scout.
Girl scout.
They're always prepared.
Are you joking?
That's right. They are ready, indeed.
That's certainly a remote answer.
You've got
him.
You should
date girlfriend, you. Girl talk, girl scout. Now, you can choose one of those three or give us one of your own if you wish. What would you like to do?
I'm going to go with a friend.
A friend. Girlfriend. All right, that's the answer that Stu gave you. Let's see where and if it shows up.
We are looking for girlfriend. May we see the $100 response? Girl talk. Stephanie gave you that one there. All right, it's up there. You're getting warm. We're looking for girlfriend. May we see the $250 response? Girl Scout is up there also.
They're worth every penny of it.
Yes, Scout. Sir.
All right.
Now, if this card shows up white with black writing, we in.
All right, we're looking for girlfriend. May we see the $500 response? Girl!
He's getting old, you're not the big one.
That's right. That puts you over $2,000 now with that additional $500. That means you play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000.
We're going to hit one yet.
Yeah, I hope you hit one yet. Now, to win the $5,000, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Please choose that celebrity now.
We were so close. Let's go again, Stu.
All right, Stu, you get ready to write. This is the question. You face me, and here we go, Stu. Please write your answer to this, a $5,000 question. Three blank. Three blank. Yikes. Okay, Stu is finished now. We call for your response, Grady. Three blank. How do you fill in that blank?
Three musketeers.
Three musketeers is his answer. Stu, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
I'm sorry. I had three roses.
Three roses.
I couldn't. Yeah. Couldn't think of anything else.
I couldn't even think of the fourth
when
rose.
When I get frustrated, I immediately think of booze. I needed another one.
Sometimes you draw a blank and they show, you know, when I play the game, that can happen. But don't worry about it. You've got an additional $500. Means you're up to $2,150. And you're going to meet another challenger. And we got another game coming up right after this comes up. Now let's greet our new player. Here is Michelle Alexander. Hello, Michelle.
Hi.
Say hello to Grady.
Hi, Grady. Thank you.
Okay. You want to tell us a little bit about the story of your life, Michelle?
Okay. I'm living in Oregon right now, going to school with my husband. And we're down here in L.A. for the summer working. And we're expecting a baby in January.
Aww. Aww. That's nice. Okay. Yeah, good luck to you. You know how this goes, don't you? You've seen the thing in operation. You know the rules. You know the challenger makes a selection. So would you go right ahead?
Could I have B, please?
You may have B. All right. It's up to you. Brand new game here, folks, so everybody plays. Pencils at the ready.
Including the baby.
Because I feel like I'm in school. I'll pick up the pencil. I like to pick up pencils in here. Yes, sir.
Jack.
Said to Mary.
No, no. Jack said, Brett was a lot blanker when I married her.
You're trying to get me in all kinds of trouble.
Jack said, Brett was a lot blanker when I married her. No peeking.
No peeking at the bride before the wedding.
Did you hear that, Michelle?
Yeah.
And you are aware that we have Jack and Brett on the program, and they are man and wife. You are aware of all that?
From time to time.
Okay.
Watch
now, would you give us your response, please?
Oh, Jack? I don't, you know, this isn't going to be a personal offense or anything, you know. Sexier?
Sexier.
You just blow it, sweetheart.
Sexier.
I shared a dressing room with her last week. That's not true at all. She's much better than she was. Yeah.
All right. Let's see if her answer scores.
Well, I certainly hope so.
Wait a minute. That's the... let's see if her answer... I don't know what I'm saying.
I'll let your mother
worry.
Let
me see your answer.
I really don't understand this. This show is getting quite racy, and they told me not to mention it, but I put younger.
Younger. Okay. No match there, Brett.
I told you you'd blow it. Younger, younger.
Younger. Okay.
Well, what I mean is, if, see, you're right. She was a lot sexier and a lot younger.
Younger? All right. So far you haven't scored with sexier, Michelle. Stephanie, let's see what you've done.
Well, assuming how crabby a woman would have to become being married to Jack that long.
Yes.
I put down the word nicer.
A lot nicer.
Well, I don't know her very well.
You can't win no matter what. What do you do
here? We may never see you after the show. I happened to hear Jack the other day said that Brett is not half the woman she used to be, so I put taller.
Okay. Betty White, Michelle is looking for the word sexier.
Well, lots of luck, aren't we all? However, I was with Stephanie. I said nicer.
Nicer.
I don't know.
All right, so Michelle, you didn't do very well with that at all, and we'll get to Grady right after we get to this. So don't go away. Time is up, and we'll pick up at this very same point next time, right in the middle of round one. You will come back, won't you?
Oh,
Michelle,
yes.
And Grady, thank you.
Way, she won't.
We thank you very much for being with us. Join us next time for Match Game 73. Gene Rayburn here. Bye.
Today's consolation prize is Charcoal Whip, a completely portable gas grill that goes anywhere. Instant flame without starter fluids or charcoal. Charcoal products of Antioch, Illinois. And a supply of Weight Watchers skim milk, satisfying big milk flavor, surprisingly delicious. Weight Watchers skim milk tastes great. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dish, is so quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.